Hey kids, welcome back to Learn with Maktoum. In the last video, mathematics first lesson, we were discussing about shapes and spatial understanding, right? In that, we have seen like about lines, right? In lines, we have straight line, curved lines. Again, in straight lines, we can see horizontal lines, vertical lines and slanted lines. Hope you remember them. Okay. So, before watching this video, make confirm that you have watched that previous video, because this video is the continuation of that video. In this video, we are going to complete the lesson 1 of your math subject. Okay. Okay. So, today what I am going to teach you in this video is, we have to study something about roll and slide. Then we will see two-dimensional shapes and three-dimensional shapes. Okay, let us start. Okay kids, now these are what? Straight objects, right? They are having like straight objects, there is no curved ring, and this is what? It is a curved object, right? Now remember, always remember, straight objects will slide, they will slide, yes or no? So consider this is a slope area. If I leave this, this is what? Sliding. So straight objects slide. If you consider this circular object or the curved object, they will roll, yes or no? They will roll. Understood? Hope you understood. Straight objects slide, curved objects roll. That is what you have to remember in rolling and sliding. Now moving to two-dimensional shapes. Hope you remember the shapes you have studied in first standard already, yes? So can you name any shapes? Like square, triangle, rectangle. Yes, you have studied, right? The same here, two-dimensional shapes. Consider this, okay? Here you can see two dimensions. What are those two dimensions? Width and the length. So, the objects with these two dimensions, which are those? Length and width, are called as two-dimensional objects. Example, this is a square, right? Square is a two-dimensional object. The same way, rectangle, triangle, these are two-dimensional objects. Hope you understood what do you mean by two-dimensional. So, if you consider this one, here you can see width, length. With that, there is one more dimension. What is this? This is height. Okay, this is height, right? So, the objects with three dimensions, which are those dimensions? Length, width and height. Those are called as three-dimensional objects. Examples are cuboid, cone, cylinder. These are three-dimensional objects. Okay. So, this is what you have to remember as a basic concepts. So, yes. Now, one more thing here. So, whenever I consider a surface or an object, it will be having edges. So you can see this is one edge, second edge, third edge and fourth edge. So it is having four edges, and whenever two edges will come and meet, that forms a corner. Whenever two edges meet, so this is one edge and this is second edge, they are meeting here, so this is what? One corner. So, like that you can see here also, one more corner, third, fourth. So, this object is having how many corners? Four corners. And coming to the circular objects, can you see any corners here? No, right? So, remember, curved objects will not have any corner. But, you can consider the edges as curved edges. Instead of considering the straight edges, you can consider here curved edges. One, two, three, four. You can say like curved edges you can consider, but there will be no corner in curved objects. Okay. And here also, can you tell me like number of edges here? Only consider this above one. One, two, three, four. So four edges are there. Corners. One, two, three, four. Four corners are there. Clear with this? Okay. So, this is what you have to remember as a basic concepts. So let us see what is given in your textbooks. I'm going to walk you through the textbook now. Okay, do concentrate, observe and learn. Okay, let's move.
Okay, so let us see these features of geometry. What rolls, what slides. So on this left side you can see sliding and on the right side you can see rolling. Okay, look at the picture. Some objects only roll and some objects only slide, but there are few which can do both. Let us see examples. So like book if you consider, or any wooden plank if you consider, their surface is plane, so they will slide. Clear with that? The objects with plane surface will slide, and the objects with curved surface will roll. For example, ball or marble. And coins if you consider, coins or carom piece if you consider, they are having both plane as well as curved surface. That's why they can roll as well as slide. Okay. Now kids, your work is to, among these objects, which objects can roll, you have to put on the roll column, you have to put right mark, and which objects can slide, that you have to mark, and which can do both, also you have to tick. The first one is having only plane surface, right? So they can slide. Second one, it is having plane surface, yes, and it is curved also, right? So it can do both. It can roll, slide, yes or no? And coming to the third one, it can roll. This will also roll. This one will slide. This one can roll and this one can roll. Clear with this? Write the names of any two objects which can only roll. This is a work for you. Already the answers are there above. You can write them. Only roll, you can write ball and marble. And only slide, you can write matchbox, yes, and notebook. Then write the names of two objects which can both roll and slide. You can write coin and carom piece. Okay, now let us see about two-dimensional shapes and their features. Okay, so look at this picture now. So what are the different shapes you can see here? So in this picture, what are the different shapes you can see? If you observe it carefully, here you can able to see one shape. Yes, this is a triangle, right? You can see it here, triangle. And if you see, this one is square. You can see two squares in the picture, right? And if you see it, this one is circle. You can see one circle. Yes or no? And this one is rectangle. This is what? Rectangle. Okay. So, this shape is called as square. This is rectangle. This one is triangle and circle. So, hope you should remember these. Okay. And one more activity given. You have to join these dots. Okay. And you have to remember the name. Okay, and you have to count them. Like in this picture, only one circle is there. So you have to write here one. And how many triangles you can see? Only one triangle. So one triangle. And how many rectangles are there? One, two, three, four. So four rectangles are there. And square, one, two. Two squares are there, so write two here. So join the dots, count them and write the number here. Okay. Now you have to practice them by drawing. Okay, you have to draw each shape here in this space. Okay. Now here one more activity they have given. Join the dots according to the numbers and name the shapes. So here one example they have given. They have joined from 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, then 4 to 1. This shape is called as square. Now the same way you have to join here. 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4. Oh, which shape is it? It is rectangle, right? R E C T A N G L E. Rectangle. Now, next one is 1 to 2, 2 to 3. This is what? Triangle. So you will write the spelling, okay? And this one is here, you have to join this one. 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4. Okay, join it correctly. This one is what? Circle. Now, color, color, what color? Let us play this game. You have to color square with yellow, rectangle with green, circle with red, triangle with black. This is the activity for you. Then while coloring, you have to count them and write the numbers here. Firstly, you have to write number of rectangles here, then number of squares, number of triangles, and lastly number of circles. Okay? Yes. Clear with this? Okay, now let us see some of the features of these shapes. You have to remember these properties of the objects. The first one, let us see about square. Square is having four sides. It is having four sides. All four sides of a square are equal. What do you mean by this? Say, this one is of 5 centimeter. Then, all sides will be of 5 centimeters only. Clear with that? These are sides of a square and all the sides of squares are equal. That you have to remember. Then, coming to the rectangle. Rectangle also has four sides. 1, 2, 3, 4. But here, opposite sides of a rectangle are equal. Means what? Say one side is 5. So opposite of this side is what? This one. So this will also be 5. And say this is 3 centimeter. Then the opposite of this side is this one. So here the opposite sides are equal. Clear with that? Then a triangle has 3 sides. Remember, always a triangle will have 3 sides. Then the circle is a shape bounded by a curved line. So what is a circle? It is a shape bounded by a curved line. This is curved line, right? There is no corner. There is no edge. Yes or no? Yes. Now, give few examples of objects which are similar to the following shapes. So they have given one example. You can write one more example here. For example, if you consider here for the rectangle, they have given an example of book. You can give matchbox. Yes. Then triangle, they have given traffic signal board beside a road. So write one example for each. Let us move on to the three-dimensional shapes. These are also called as solid shapes. You can observe the objects in the picture given below. Like this is one object. This is one object. Like observe each and every object. And let us see what you can understand from here. If you see these objects given, these looks like what? Cuboid. So how a cuboid is drawn? I will show you. Okay, first draw a rectangle. Behind that one, draw one more rectangle. Okay. So that becomes your cuboid. Okay. Like this, you can draw a cuboid. Now, this object looks like cube. So the difference between cube and cuboid, you can say like this cube is nothing but the 3D representation of square, you can say. And cuboid, you can say like 3D representation of rectangle. Here you can draw one square, okay, and behind that draw one more square and join the edges. So this is what a cube, okay. Then comes your cylinder. So cylinder will be like this. Okay, this is what a cylinder shape. Then cone, draw triangle and down, and the lastly, don't draw the edge, you can draw curved edge. And now match the objects to the shape they resemble as shown in the example. So like this, this one matches with the cylinder, right? So they have matched it to cylinder shape. So other objects we have to match now. this one looks like what? Cuboid, right? So this is a cuboid. Then this one is what? Cone. So match it to cone. Then this one is a sphere. So sphere. Then this one is cube. Understood? Now here you have to observe something. So if you see the table, okay, Muddu and Ammu and Appu, Tinku, Chotu and Chin, these are all friends. Chotu and five others of his friends are playing a game. What is that game? Ammu has tied a cloth to her eyes and clapping her hands. Others are moving around the table. When Ammu stops clapping, immediately all of them stand wherever they are. Those who are away from the corners have to leave the game. Others continues to play. So this is a small game. Okay, around this table, all these kids will be playing. Okay, they will be moving around it. So whenever Ammu stops clapping, they have to stop there only. So whoever is not there at the corner, they have to leave the game. Okay, now if you observe the picture given above and find who has to leave the game, can you guess who has to leave the game? Muddu. Why? Because Muddu is not at the corner, right? So where she is standing then? She is standing at the edge. Okay, who are standing at the corners of the table? Chinu, Chotu, Appu and Tinku. Okay, where is Muddu standing? Edge. Okay. Okay, hope you understood about the edge. So let me show you here. So this is what the edge. Hope you understood. One edge, two edge, three and four. Four edges are there. And where these edges will meet, that is what a corner. So one corner, two corner, third and fourth. Understood? Okay, let us see in detail now. Some of the practices are given here. Most of the objects around us have straight edges. Yes or no? Most of them are straight edges. Some of them also having curved edges. You can see this is what curved edge is. Clear? These are straight edges. Now, name any five objects around you which have straight edges. So you can say notebook, matchbox, TV, phone, table. They are having straight edges. So then list any five objects which have curved edges. You can consider wheels of vehicles, ball, etc. Do objects having straight edges have corners? Yes. So the objects which are having the straight edges, they will have corners. Whereas curved edges, they will not have any corner. Understood? There is one activity they have given to you. You can try this out. Take a piece of paper, rectangular in shape. Count the corners of the paper. Now, how many edges does the paper have? Four edges, right? Fold a corner of the paper as shown. So fold it at one corner. Now, how many corners does the paper have? Three. How many edges it has? It is having four edges only. Fold another corner of the paper. Now count the number of edges and corner of the paper. So try this out. Okay. Now observe the list of objects given below. Mark for the objects having corners. Count the edges and corners and write them. So first an example they have given here. So does the object have corners? Yes, it has. And edges, how many edges it has? 12 edges. How can you tell the 12 edges? Let me show you. It is a cube, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4, yes, 5, 6, 7, 8, right, 9, 10, 11, 12. So these are all 12 edges. Now coming to the corners. So let me show you the corners. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 8 corners. Understood? Okay. Now ball. This is what? Is it having any corners? No, right? Now, rubber. If you consider it is having corners, yes. How many edges? 12 edges, 8 corners. Same as the cube. Okay, because it is cuboid, same number of edges and same number of corners. Then cucumber, no. Then paper, yes, it has corners. How many corners and edges? 4 edges, 4 corners. How? 1, 2, 3, 4 edges. 1 corner, 2, 3, 4. Understood? To identify the shadows of solid figures. So you can see, these are the solid figures. You can see their shadow right here. You can see the shadows. Okay, now you have to match their shadows now. I have already matched. This is glass, then bottle, then a can. So this is how you're going to match them. This completes the chapter shapes and spatial understanding. Okay, so hope you understood about lines, straight lines, and the different shapes, two-dimensional shapes and three-dimensional shapes. This completes the lesson 1. I'm going to see you in the lesson 2 now. Okay, till then, take care, revise, read. Okay, bye-bye.